presentation is I'm reading right, the cultural and geolocation aspects of communication on Twitter. Elena Daehnhardt.
Good afternoon. I'm Elena and I'm presenting our paper on communication in Twitter and how is it influenced by user cultural backgrounds. This paper is part of my PhD research, which aims to uncover user cultural preferences and further adapt user preferences to use them for adapting web applications for specific user needs. User preferences and traits related to user cultural backgrounds could be further exploited in e-commerce, e-learning, and social networking websites. So my previous paper uncovered cultural microblogging differences for people from 5 selected countries. In this work, I work in exploring how people communicate in Twitter. And my next paper is to exploit the differences of communication on Twitter for creation of recommendation strategies. So the next I outline our research questions, present our approach, and describe our results and go into the plans for future work. So the main idea behind this study is that we want to really see how people communicate in Twitter and how we could perhaps exploit user cultural differences in building culture-aware recommendation strategies. For doing this, we need to really know the country of users, how we actually find the countries on user on Twitter. So there are quite many works which work on detecting precise locations out of Twitter content, metadata, and other features which might relate to different sources on the web. But what we do, we don't go into the precise locations, instead we detect only country locations. And the first question was how we could actually exploit Twitter for finding locations, how we can use content or perhaps metadata for finding country locations in Twitter. Which features are important? Finally, we work on analyzing communication in Twitter, analyzing particularly user replies. And we used Twitter-specific features for building response models, particularly replies. And we next analyze which features are really the most important for finding user interests in their followers. So this is our approach. What we do, we perform kind of two big steps. So first we collect our data set using streaming API and Python library. And then based on the content and metadata associated with tweets, we create user profiles, which include Twitter specific features such as hashtag usage, usage of mentions of other users, tweeting times, and other features which I'll later explain. And we use these features for building user profiles, which then we aggregate for building our prediction model used for predicting countries of origin of user followers. So on the second stage, we have actually data from the followers, the tweet of the followers information and user-related profiles. And then we want to see what is important really to get user responses on Twitter. For this, we built a kind of model which is based on logistic regression and also decision trees. And with help of these models, we find out the most important features. Here we see the countries which we follow on Twitter. This include 13 most tweeting countries. And we actually grouped these countries in three main groups. These groups is we adopted from the sociological study by Richard Lewis. This study relates human behavior in real life with different nations or different countries. And in my previous work, I found out actually that people also microblog differently. And we further explore this. We see that we mark, this is actually our users come from different countries. We mark them in according to this cultural dimensions of Lewis. So here we see the main features we exploit. This includes the feature sets. Here we see the top five feature sets based on the user related information. And the last one is features which you extract from the followers network. So the first feature set is very simple. It's just language defined in the user profile, which we use for finding out countries of the users. Second is behavior, it's activity-based features, which we extract from the tweets of the users and metadata. Third is a meta feature set, which is created based on the joining the strings of language, the most frequent time zone, and also location field. Location field is a free text form which actually users fill out with any arbitrary content, which can be humoristic, some message, some phrase. Well, in a previous research, it shows that it's not so really useful for predicting countries of the users. And this is why we join this location field and language and actually we used also the time zone for building this meta feature. Next, it was very interesting for us to start with to see if we could actually exploit metadata from the tweets of the user and from tweets also of the followers. And if you could use this metadata for finding the country of users. However, it was difficult for us, and actually about 2% of tweets in our sample data set were actually containing the geographic locations. Here we see the language model, which we see the distribution of countries and languages, and we see that some of the countries, such as Malaysia, Indonesia, here, this is a two-digit language code. So they have quite a large fraction of English languages defined in the user profiles. And this is why, when we use just languages, these users might be associated with their own country of origin. Here we see the performance of our classifier. Here we see that user-related data, when we use the language, we achieve only 88% cross-validation accuracy. When we combine the language with location field and with time zone, then we achieve the best performance for the user-related data, when we use only user-related data. And we also can see, if you look into this followers feature set. Followers features we extract from replies of the followers of our users. And we see that it's quite a comparable performance with the language feature set. However, when we combine the user language and a followers feature set, we achieve the best possible performance for our feature sets. Here we achieve 94% of cross-validation accuracy for in our experiments of country detection. So we exploit a decision trees for building car classification model, and we actually it's quite easy now to see the importance of the features. Here we see the most important features. Class is a user language. This is follows country, follows time zone, follows influence. Influence is a widely used feature in the Twitter research. It's fraction of followers divided by sum of followers and friends of the users. This is a tweeting time on weekends and influence on the users. So next we moved to actually to looking into relationship between how we can see the replies, what is important for getting user replies on Twitter. And when we look into the replies of the users, we see that most of the replies coming actually from the same countries of origin as our initial users. And that's why we thought perhaps much of the user countries and much of the languages, it's important for getting user replies on Twitter. But as we see later, this is not so, as we found out in our experiments. Here we see the results of our decision tree and logistic regression marginal effects, and we highlighted the most significant features by green column blocks, and we see that these most significant features with p less than 0.05, and we see in logistic regression results the country match is really not so significant, such as dimension match. Dimension is a region where we categorized countries belonging to the same culture of origin in accordance with Lewis model of cultures. And then we see that, for example, the marginal effect allows to see how big the effect of these features which we found out. And we see that dimension match actually goes to like if the countries have a match of dimensions, if the users and followers, they come from the same cultural origin or from the same region, then the probability of user responses increases by 23%. When language matches, what we assumed initially, this is not so significant, such as follow language matches. In this case, in opposite follow language match, we got a negative relationship. Our response rates decreased in 43%. And the next feature, which is interesting, it's influence. Yeah, user influence was not so significant that such as followers influence. And when followers influence was growing, the response rate from the friends on Twitter was actually decreasing. So the more influence of the followers, the less probability of getting replies from them. So to summarize our findings on country prediction, we using the Twitter-specific features, we were able to find out user countries of origin with accuracy of more than 90%. We found the most important features, and in respect to predicting user replies, we also found out what is the most important for getting user replies on Twitter. We found that countries are not so important as getting actually users from the same cultural backgrounds on Twitter. We found that if followers coming from very influential networks, it's very difficult to really to get the responses on Twitter. And another findings that when the majority language of followers of the users and the followers match, then we have less responses from these followers. So in future work, we are planning actually to explore these cultural behavior patterns and differences in communication for building our recommendation strategies based on the cultural dimensions of the users. And we are going actually to move into content-related features, explore hashtags more in depth, and also to follow Twitter for a longer time period to see how the cultural behavior patterns change over time. So we want to build temporary user profiles. So thank you very much for listening. I will be happy to answer your questions. Thank you.
Go to page number 10.
Yes.
Slide
10. 13. Yes.
10.
Which?
10.
10.
Have you classified based on these US previous slides?
Previous slide.
Mm-hmm. They are active. Why US, UK, on which? What is the basis for classification? Reactive, multi-active, this country?
So actually, this is the locations which we follow. This is the top 13 countries. How we find out the users from these countries? So it's a very interesting question. So our data collection was done in several steps. First, we collected a sample set of tweets for a period of some days. And then based on the geographical information attached to tweets, we see the from which countries users coming. And then we have a set of such as 20,000 users coming from particular countries, which we then follow for a period of time about 1 week. And then when we follow this user set, it's quite interesting because we're not only getting the tweets of the initial users, we also have tweets of the followers. We get also replies. And this is quite nice for our experimental setup, since we have not only initial users, but also replies with which data we can build our response model. And this is this groups, this is the cultural dimensions which we group countries in accord with Lewis model of cultures. I hope that answer. Thank you, Tom.
Very specific countries, because there are a lot of tweets is now worldwide. Yeah. So I was interested why specific. Anyway.
Yeah. Yes. Well, actually, it's a very nice question because we based this research on the Lewis model of cultures, which might be not so known, such as Hofstede model. But why we employ this model? Because the Lewis model of cultures actually focuses on communication in real life. And what we are trying to find is differences in communication in Twitter and microblogs. This is why we employ the Lewis model of cultures. Thank you.
Very great question. Is this suite attributes are very sensitive for the result? If you risk different models.
Well, actually, there are many factors playing a role in this training the models. Before, when we had only 5 countries in our set, then we exploited different features. When we tried to apply that feature set for the extended country set, like 13 countries in this case, then those features didn't work. That's why we needed to further adapt our feature set and increase it to improve the accuracy of country's prediction. So basically, this model works with 13 countries, which we. To you mean to choose of parameters?
Yeah, because if you like in US, how it will be active, then what happens basically?
Yeah, this is a good question. So, of course, most of our tweets coming from United States. And it depends which feature set we use. If we use language data set, then of course many users misclassified into the United States group. If we use a meta feature set, when we explore also the most frequent time zone and a location field, then this becomes less sensitive to the country selected. Thank you.